The general has nothing more at heart than the health of the troops.
In the early years of the American Revolution, the Continental Army had more to fight than enemy soldiers. Smallpox was raging through the colonies, in some places killing up to half of the white settlers who fell sick, and taking an even deadlier toll on Native Americans, some of whom had been deliberately infected as a weapon of occupation. The British Redcoats weren't too bothered. The majority had already survived the disease as children, but American-born soldiers were at great risk. George Washington, who'd had smallpox himself as a teenager, knew that many people were reluctant to be inoculated or protected by receiving a less deadly form of the virus. But facing devastating losses, Washington wrote to Congress that he had determined to inoculate all the troops and new recruits. This decision undoubtedly saved lives and was probably a big part of why they won the war. Vaccines are one of humanity's greatest triumphs, and their development arose from knowledge across the globe. People have been using antiviral technology for centuries. The type of inoculation they used in the Revolutionary War, rubbing infected pus onto a healthy person to give them a milder case, originated hundreds of years ago in Asia and Africa. Lady Mary Wortley Montagu brought it from Turkey to Europe. An enslaved black man named Onesimus introduced it from West Africa to North America. In the late 18th century, Edward Jenner discovered that patients exposed to cowpox were then protected from smallpox. He called the procedure vaccination, after the Latin word for cow. By 1900, we had vaccines against cholera, rabies, typhoid, and plague. And over the next 100 years, things really started to snowball. Vaccines offer incredible protection against formerly deadly diseases, and vaccination now saves more lives than any other medical procedure. But how do vaccines work? Let's look at what they're trying to do in the first place. Our natural immune system is pretty incredible. Think of it like a chef with lots of recipes. It can cook up resistance to a whole slew of diseases. Vaccines, then, are like cookbooks, instructions that teach our chefs great new recipes. Most vaccines use either a weakened or dead form of a virus, or a harmless piece of its shell to excite our immune system. They deliver the ingredients for immunity to our bodies. And using those ingredients, our immune systems whip up a recipe to protect us from a virus. So if we ever meet that virus down the road, our immune system remembers how to get rid of it. For decades, researchers have been working on another type of vaccine, a messenger RNA, or mRNA vaccine. mRNA is already inside all of us. Its job is to relay instructions for making proteins, molecules that do all kinds of work in our bodies, like keeping our cells together, helping our muscles move, and protecting us from viruses. An mRNA vaccine delivers really specific and efficient instructions to our immune cells. In the case of COVID-19, the mRNA tells our bodies how to make a spike protein from the shell of SARS-CoV-2, which causes COVID-19. Our immune cells cook up the recipe and voila, produce a harmless but recognizable spike. So our immune system learns how to spot and destroy SARS-CoV-2 without ever being exposed to the actual virus. When the COVID-19 pandemic hit, we were able to develop mRNA vaccines so quickly because researchers had been working on the science behind them for more than 30 years. But a safe and successful vaccine takes more than scientists. For a vaccine to be recognized as safe and efficient, it has to go through numerous tests. The three final phases are testing in volunteers, folks from all kinds of backgrounds. Each involves more people at every level, and all new vaccines go through these trials, including the COVID-19 vaccines. Scientists, medical professionals, and volunteers from all over the world made this happen faster than ever before. But even as vaccination numbers climb in the COVID-19 pandemic, there's more work to be done. People must have access to vaccines and the education to move from hesitance to confidence. It's within our power to end this pandemic. and vaccines will get us there.